Finally tonight, tomorrow marks 10 years since I took over anchoring this show from my mentor and friend, Britt Hume, and it has been quite a ride. I've been blown away this week as the Special Report staff surprised me by collecting messages from friends and colleagues, sound bites that have run on the show all week. And now I'm told they have a final surprise, capping the week with a look back. You may have noticed, after 2,851 shows as Special Report with Britt Hume, this show has a new name. Welcome to Washington. I'm Bret Baier, and this is a special edition of Special Report.
You know, he is a killer. I mean, he's clearly executing people. And
it's not just Washington punditry.
No, listen.
That they're not going to keep their doctor.
Bret, you got to let me finish.
Bret has a mastery of a tough thing, and that is the task of being interesting and being fair. He's not just some TV personality. This is a journalist.
At times, you thought it would be a model for the nation.
You're wrong, Bret.
Bret,
this is an unusual interview. All right, let's do it again.
I've heard others say that neither you nor your lawyers have been apprised that you are a target of the investigation. Is that true?
Absolutely true.
Current or former staff?
Absolutely not.
You and your staff deleted nearly 32,000 emails.
Let me clarify this.
You don't remember?
Dude, this was like 2 years ago. We're still talking about the most mundane process.
It is the thing that everybody is talking about.
How's your relationship with President Trump now?
Well, it was a little
rocky there for a while. You think that you still have the confidence of President Trump. How do you and how do America's other Arab allies view U.S. leadership in the region now?
Difficult questions.
That got the English response.
His interview with James Comey in this very studio was as good an interview on television as I've ever seen in my life. I've never seen an anchor more prepared. I've never seen an anchor cut through nonsense more politely but more firmly.
Someone's not telling the truth here. Is it the former attorney general or you?
No, actually, I think we're both telling the truth.
One of the special qualities that Bret has is his ability to create a special moment. For instance, in the first primary debate in Cleveland, when he asked all of the candidates,
can I see hands? Who is unwilling tonight to pledge your support to the eventual nominee of the Republican Party and pledge to not run an independent campaign against that person? Mr. Trump.
That was Bret's moment.
The thing about Bret is he wants to be where the action is. He wants to talk to people on the ground. He wants to see what's happening in person and relay that information for the viewers.
We are just a few feet away from North Korea. This is the DMZ.
Good to see you. 12th time.
It's about 2 hours by Royal Saudi Air Force prop plane from Riyadh to the southern border with Yemen.
Just yesterday, a rocket was fired from here, landing somewhere here.
From Amman, the capital of Jordan. That's it for this special report from the White House.
Fair, balanced, and unafraid.
Bret is, honest to God, one of the most genuine human beings I've ever met. A lot of people say, Katie, don't you want to move on? And I say, well, if you work for Bret, you'd want to stay here too. He just is such a fun boss.
Here he is pumping mustard into his bottle. Why is Bret Baier hoarding mustard?
Have you ever seen the movie Caddyshack?
What?
The last dance at the last ball was 69 seconds for President Obama, so... obviously, he's into busting a move. How are you still awake? I mean, this is what, 26 hours?
Well, I don't have a choice because you want to do an interview.
If you had a reality TV show like Donald Trump does, what would it be?
Bear made me sweat. One look at him and I started sweating.
Wow, that was awesome. Thank you so much. Many different weight classes in that video there over 10 years. Doug Rohrbach, my executive producer, has been here from the very beginning. Can we show the control room real quick? Doug, along with an amazing special report team, correspondents, producers, editors, technical folks, all working really hard every day to make this show work, to cover news here and around the world. When I took over for Bret, he said two things to me. One, it's not about you. And two, let the news drive the show. And it's an equation that has worked. I just added on to what Bret built here. So I don't make a lot of predictions, but I guarantee you this. There will be a lot of news in 2019, and we will continue to cover it here, fair, balanced, and unafraid.